My luxury kitchen and bath brand Kohler continues its arts support program in Asia. The arts program started in the 70s when Kohler in the U.S. accepted some 400 artists as interns every year. Now, last year, Kohler began an annual Southeast Asian arts exhibit involving Thailand, Indonesia, Singapore, Malaysia, Vietnam, and the Philippines. This week, Kohler opens the Philippine leg of this ASEAN arts exhibit called Kohler Bold Art Asia. So joining us this morning are Kohler's Vice President for Kitchen and Bath in Asia and Australasia, Ms. Angel Yang, and Filipino ceramic artist and sculptor Hadrian Mendoza. Good morning, guys. Thanks for coming in.
Good morning.
Okay, well, this is something that's different, cool. I think that's very cool. I think some people may be familiar with, of course, the brand, Kohler as the brand, but maybe not as aware of the art support program that's also, it's also alongside Kohler as the brand that people know for their kitchen or their bath products and accessories, right? But this has been going on for a very long time.
Yeah, Kohler, you know, as you know, Kohler this year is 143 years history. So Kohler was founded in 1873 in U.S. So all the top management and, you know, all the leaders has been very passionate, you know, put a lot of dedication to the art program. So we have a long history, you know, between Kohler and art. So the first, you know, start actually was in 1973, almost 40 years ago. So in U.S. we have art and industry this program. So since then there are like hundreds of the artists that participate in this program, and there are a lot of collaboration between the art and also our industry craftsmanship.
That's exactly what I was just going to ask. I mean, it's a jumping off point for innovative new designs on the craftsmanship side for for Kohler. And so this is kind of a way to jumpstart that. But does it does the actual exhibit, like the one that we're talking about now, which actually has a theme, Asian contemporary art rooted in the past, looking into the future, does that revolve around the
so
the craftsmanship products?
So, you know, we expanded this whole, you know, art program in Asia, and we invited, you know, six artists from six different countries, and everyone, you know, basically created two masterpieces. And the theme, we give a theme, you know, to all the artists that basically is rooted in the past and looking to the future. So we would like to see the evolving in the designs and keep innovating, you know, have innovative products.
And of course, one of those artists being Hadrian here, who's representing the Philippines. Hadrian, you've been involved in ceramic art, but you've kind of identified yourself as an accidental artist to having gotten into an accidental sculpture, is it? Or
Yeah, well, I was a business major in college, and my final year, I took ceramics, and I fell in love with it, and I've been doing it ever since.
So a complete world away from where you thought you would be, and now you find yourself as a ceramic artist.
Yes, but the business background does help, you know, but my passion's really in the arts.
Tell us about this exhibit. Tell us about the work that you contributed to the exhibit.
I created two pieces. The first one is titled Time, and it's about environmental change. I created a series of 20 heads, which are the Bulul, rice terrace gods, and the farmers who give us the rice. And the environment has has been damaged by the people, and the heads get damaged as it comes around, like a clock in time. We're running out of time. But the eyes are still looking forward, and meaning there is hope. And we have to make changes now to save the environment for our kids and for the future.
Hopefully we'll get a chance to maybe see some visuals of the pieces that you created there for the exhibit. That's beautiful. You're known for really taking aspects of the Philippine culture, of the Philippine tradition into your artwork. And so, especially even with this exhibit, you've managed to do that as well.
And the second piece I made is the Manunggul jar, which is one of the most prized pieces in Philippine history. It's a burial jar where you put your belongings when you die with a person. I made mine with a ring, which is empty. My belief is you don't take anything with you into the next life, but basically how you affect the world, and that's what you leave behind.
That sounds really beautiful. It's a way for, what a wonderful way for artists from other countries and for people who go and visit the exhibit to also learn so much about the culture of the Philippines and of the other countries that are involved in the exhibit. Mm-hmm. What did you want really people to walk away with? Looking rooted in the past, looking into the future when it comes to the Philippines and as an artist, what do you want people to interpret from your designs?
From my pieces, basically to give back, to help save the earth, mm-hmm. and to let go of material possessions. Mm-hmm. And also, of course, it's important to know that Kohler really supports the arts, mm-hmm. and the focus of this whole thing is really on the artists, mm-hmm. and the art pieces, which, you know, I'm very thankful for, mm-hmm. to be part of.
How did you feel that? How did you feel that support and that focus on the artists and on the art pieces as far as this exhibit was concerned?
Well, number one, the way they treat the artists, they gave us a lot of freedom. Mm-hmm. You know, the sky's open for you to interpret, and they know how to respect us, and they know how an artist thinks, mm-hmm. because you can see the art in their works.
And supporting,
yeah. So all the artists I know involved are very happy, you know, to be part of this thing. And when the exhibit travels, they really focus on us, which is really great.
Will some pieces of the exhibit be found in Kohler products later down the line, or be inspired by?
I think, you know, as we say, the inspiration, mm-hmm. is very important word. So some of our products definitely, you know, inspired by the ideas, you know, craftsmanship, you know, the texture, you know, so a lot of ideas we can incorporate, you know, into our product design. So it's good collaboration, you know, between a Kohler and also the art.
Beautiful. Well, that's a way of having a kind of that inspiration and the meeting of cultures. Have a real hand in inspiring future, mm-hmm. designs from Kohler. The exhibit is ongoing
now.
It's on it's at Greenbelt 5. Please let us know the details where people can check it out.
Yeah, it's going to be a week, you know, show in, mm-hmm. the Greenbelt.
Okay, so we can see your pieces there.
Yes,
Adrian,
it's in Greenbelt 5, mm-hmm. second level gallery, and there's, mm-hmm. 12 pieces from 6 artists, and it's a beautiful setup. And
fantastic.
Yeah, check it out.
Okay,
yeah.
And aside from this, of course, where can people also take a look at your work? Any pieces that you're also working on that maybe people might be interested in?
Not right now?
Yes,
well,
yes.
I have a show coming up in December at Ayala Museum.
Great. Mm-hmm.
Two-person show with my wife, Kim.
Ooh.
So we're preparing for that, and we're preparing.
What's the theme around that? What's that
the
going
to
be?
The theme, we don't know yet.
Okay.
But we do. It's about two people coming together and creating works as one.
Oh, that's beautiful.
That's all I can say.
That's all we can say for now. And the rest of it will unfold within the months. Okay,
that's
so
right.
Do check out the exhibit over at Greenbelt 5. And later on, if they like what they see, also check out what you and your wife have in store. Thank you so much for joining us, Hadrian and Angel.
Thank you.
Have a great time at the exhibit. As
Thank